Good morning to everybody. So what we learnt yesterday, diagonal of a parallelogram. Diagonals of a parallelogram divides into two congruent triangles, am I right? What we learnt yesterday, the diagonals of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Okay. We will see the proof for this one. So suppose this is a parallelogram, it's a diagonal, okay. So alternating triangles are what? Equal. Alternating triangles are what? Equal. So ABCD is a parallelogram. Therefore, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle CDB. What is that? CDB. Am I right, dear? So by which congruence rule? Side angle by ASA. Okay, by ASA congruence rule. So by CPCT, what and all we can say that? By CPCT, you can say that. Yes. AB equal to CD and BC equal to it should be D, right? I think here we made a mistake. ABD then CDB. Okay, sorry here. AB equal to CD and then BD equal to, yes, DB common, you will get that. Okay, fine. Now, after that, yes, AD equal to CB, AD equal to CB, and then angle A equal to angle C. Angle A equal to angle C, you can say that. Am I right? Angle A equal to angle C. Okay, and then if you are considering a diagonal AC, then you can say that angle B equal to angle D. So in a parallelogram, what is that? Two pairs of opposite sides are equal and two pairs of opposite angles are equal. Okay, then what is the next one? Yes, diagonals bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other. Second one is what? Diagonals bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other in a parallelogram. So it's a parallelogram. The diagonal AC and BD intersect at a point O, given that ABCD is a parallelogram. So therefore AB is parallel to DC and AD is parallel to BC, you can say that. Therefore AB is parallel to DC and AD is parallel to BC. Okay. So this angle equal to this angle, am I right? And then this angle equal to this angle, am I right? Okay, we will consider these two triangles so that we can take these two angles now, am I right dear? Here what are we trying to prove? That OA equal to OC and OB equal to OD. Am I right? Now, in triangle OAB and OCD, in triangle OAB and triangle OCD. Here we are going to prove these two triangles are congruent. Am I right here?
Yes.
OAB and OCD. Okay. Now tell me, what AB equal to DC we can say? Because in a parallelogram, what? Two parts of opposite sides are parallel and equal. Therefore, AB equal to DC we can say that. AB equal to CD, it is given. After that, what we can say? OAB equal to angle OCD. Angle OAB equal to angle OCD. Since AB is parallel to DC. Otherwise, alternate interior angle. Alternate interior angles. OAB equal to angle OCD. Are you getting it here? And then, one more thing is what? What you can say that? One more thing. That is OBA, angle OBA equal to angle ODC. The same reason. What is the reason? Alternate interior angles here. Therefore, by which congruent rule? ASA. Okay. Side, that is angle, side angle. By ASA congruent rule, triangle OAB is congruent to triangle OCD. Am I right here? Then, therefore, by CPCT, what we can say? Therefore, by CPCT, you can say that by CPCT, you can say that. What is meant by CPCT? Yes, corresponding parts of congruence triangle. Corresponding parts of congruence triangle. By CPCT, you can say that OA equal to OC. By CPCT, you can say that OA equal to OC and OB equal to OD. OB equal to OD. Am I right here? Yes. After that, what is the next property? In a parallelogram, adjacent angles are supplementary. In a parallelogram, adjacent angles are what? Supplementary. That is very simple. Shall I rub this part? Yes. Adjacent angles are supplementary. A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. Here we are trying to say that what we are trying to say, that angle A plus angle B is equal to 180, angle B plus angle C equal to 180, angle C plus angle D equal to 180, angle D plus angle A equal to 180 degree. Am I right here? Yes. Now, AB is what parallel to? DC. What is that? AB is parallel to what? DC. Am I right? AB is parallel to DC. So, AB is parallel to DC and AD is a transversal. AD is a transversal. AB is parallel to DC and AD is a transversal. So what you can conclude that these are the co-interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Which one? Angle A and angle D are the co-interior angles on the same side of the transversal. So therefore, angle A plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. And again, AB is parallel to DC and BC is a transversal. And BC is a transversal. So what we can conclude that angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degree because co-interior angle on the same side of the transversal is supplementary. You have to write down the reason every go. Co-interior angle. Here then, AD is parallel to BC and DC is a transversal. Therefore, angle D plus angle C equal to 180 degree. Since co-interior angles. Then, AD is parallel to BC. This one you have to prove. AD is parallel to BC and AB is a transversal. Which one this is? AD is parallel to BC and AB is a transversal. Therefore, angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degrees. Since co-interior angles. Am I right here? Yes. So now we've seen all the properties of a parallelogram and then tomorrow we will start with the which one? Rectangle. Okay, properties of a rectangle. The tomorrow we will discuss. Thank you everybody. Thank you.